45,000 kilometers, 1,655 days, 25 countries, and countless encounters. In 2019, we embarked on a journey from Germany to explore the world, to cycle as far as possible by land, and then to reach Japan by ship. Now, almost 5 years later, we are still on the road. Is Japan our destination? Or is the journey itself what truly matters? What we've learned is that there's no perfect route. You never know where you will pitch your tent the next day and what surprises or challenges await. Or what encounters will change our lives forever. What have we learned? Even after climbing the highest mountain, there's always a descent. We've experienced good and bad days, learned about countless ways of life, found solidarity and trust, and most importantly, discovered a lot about ourselves. Also check our main channel. It's in German, but you can find English subtitles at most of our videos. Recently, we cycled through Vietnam, Cambodia, and Thailand. Just as we were exploring only half of Thailand by bicycle, our visa expired. To continue traveling, we had to leave Thailand. But this aligned perfectly with our plans to continue our personal yoga journey and deepen our knowledge. Last year, we completed a yoga teacher training in Rishikesh in India. Yoga for us is a holistic practice that unites body, mind, and soul.
Willkommen zurück in Indien.
Es tut so gut,
ja, wir sind wieder in Indien. Ja, vor einem Jahr waren wir schon mal hier, haben Yoga gemacht und so. Und jetzt auf zur Runde 2.
Wir sind in der Dining Hall hier mit gegessen, gefrühstückt, Abendessen. Da drüben ist die Küche. Und es ist mittlerweile kurz nach 6 Uhr morgens. Wir haben die Verspätung wieder reingeholt vom Zug. Und wow, ich bin schon gespannt. Wir sind schon rumgeführt worden. Wir haben schon die Halle gesehen, wo wir Yoga machen dürfen. Und ja, wir sind schon gespannt. Jetzt warten wir nur noch, bis das Zimmer fertig ist. Und dann, let's go. Wir haben unser Zimmer bezogen. Weil wir auch hier arbeiten und Videos produzieren und Beiträge, haben wir uns hier schon eine Workstation eingerichtet. Gell, Dani? Und wir haben gerade schon gefrühstückt und gleich in ein paar Minuten geht's zur Orientierungsrunde und dann, ja, gibt's die Feuerzeremonie.
So, es geht gleich los. Feuerzeremonie, ist schon fast alles aufgebaut.
Shiva, I hope you heard some of the name. Lord Shiva, have you heard? Lord Ganesha, the god with the long trunk, like an elephant face. Yes. Then the goddess Parvati in the form of the feminine mother nature. So they reflect them for the different element, and we worship for the different gods in the form of that. Then the second part is going to be like a havan, which is going to be like a fire ceremony, where we are using those kind of a different herbs. We have put, offer this up into the fire. So these herbs are very selected from the different great plants from the Ayurveda systematically, you can say. So when we use these herbs, when we burn these herbs, so the smoke is going to come out, it purifies the air surrounding us. So that is why in India it's very common every day in every home we do these kind of rituals. So for us, for the person. Yeah. And then the last part is going to be, that will be the Kirtana session. That is going to be the part of the Bhakti Yoga. There we will use, we will chant some mantra, we will dance, we will clap, we will move or something. It is just like an evolving, giving your shape, connecting to the higher self. In India, which we say spirituality, connected to the gods, or you can say in the other form, connect to the nature as well.
So a kirtan is something we create together. So we are all one band, we are all one voice. So please embrace your voice, sing with us.
Wir sind jetzt unterwegs hier. Heute ist Ganga Aarti, der erste Tag. Mega cool. Da ist Affe. Und jetzt geht's zur Zeremonie. Das wollen wir schon. Der Daniel ist im Bett geblieben, der ist fix und fertig. Wir sind ja in der Früh um 5 angekommen und genau. Cool.
An important part of the training is Hatha Yoga, the original form of yoga from which many other styles such as Ashtanga, Vinyasa, Kundalini or Bikram Yoga have evolved. Hatha promotes the balance between body and mind, which helps you to reduce stress, promotes flexibility and has many other positive effects. Breathwork, meditation and mindful movement are combined. They naturally slow us down, making us more mindful and fully present in the moment. This feels very familiar to us. It's almost like the slow, deliberate pace of our bicycle journey, where we are constantly reminded to be in the here and now. Pranayama, the art of conscious breath control. Pranayama techniques not only cleans our respiratory system, but also strengthen our prana, our life force. We discovered many parallels between yoga and our bicycle journey. You may have noticed how your breath becomes shallow and rapid when you are stressed, and how even a deep breath can help you calm down.
Oh, Frühstück! Oh, meine absolute Lieblingszeit. Der Daniel isst schon. Und wie schmeckt's?
Hervorragend.
Hervorragend. Wir haben hier einen Chai, einen roten Beetesaft. Das sind Papaya. Pickles, meine absolute Lieblingsnebenspeise, sauer eingelegtes Karotten und Mango. Hier haben wir Porridge und ich habe die Namen leider vergessen, aber sehr, sehr lecker und ich freue mich riesig darauf.
When teaching a class, it's important to consider the needs of the participants. Some may have injuries or anatomical limitations. Proper alignment helps create stability and balance.
You see, you see, she already feel that. It's like moving the foot out, taking the foot, and then here. And this strap is little high, where you tie the belt.
We also have anatomy lessons to understand which muscles are involved in specific movements, how the systems of the human body, like respiration, circulation or hormones, function, and which helpful measures can assist students with pain or illness through yoga. When we are cycling, our posture has a huge impact on our riding and, of course, our well-being. Now we understand even more what we can do when we are climbing uphill for hours, or experiencing pain during cycling, or simply how a single targeted movement can make a difference in cycling.
So, der zweite Tag ist cool. War voll cool. Second day is over. Und wir sind hier gerade beim Abendessen.
Auberginen, ja. Super gut, der Auberginenmatsch, und es schmeckt herrlich.
Foreign product inside our body, we start feeling a sneezing or our body start expelling away, you know, right? So in such condition, utter the sound ma. Utter the sound ma.
Saturdays at the school are always Kriya days, which means we cleanse our respiratory or digestive systems.
Keep chanting.
Today, along with the nasal rinsing, we also do sutraneti. This involves threading a rubber string through the nose and pulling it from the throat, gently drawing the string through the nasal and throat passages.
Bend forward. Can you give the bucket? Now, hold first with this hand. Put this hand
Such
inside.
Practices should always be done with an experienced teacher.
Grab, just grab. Flossing very smoothly, not fast, very gently. And very slowly take out from your mouth. Slowly take out from your mouth.
Look at some cheesecake.
Guten Morgen, heute ist es Sonntag, wir haben einen freien Tag, aber es bedeutet auch Selbstpraxis und wir müssen eine Stunde vorbereiten für eine Hatha-Klasse, eine Hatha-Yoga-Klasse. Unser tägliches Aufstehen sieht so aus, dass der Wecker klingelt um 5:30 und um 6 haben wir die erste Stunde und jetzt sonntags an unserem freien Tag, kurz nach 6, klingelt der Wecker. Wir haben zwar keine Stunde, aber wir lernen trotzdem und stehen trotzdem auf, damit wir den Rhythmus beibehalten. Ist auch schon ganz schön tough.
We've also practiced teaching classes in various disciplines, such as Ashtanga Yoga, which follows a dynamic sequence of poses. But it wasn't always that easy. Originally, the asanas were developed to find a stable and comfortable seat for meditation. Meditation is a practice where you focus your mind and find a quiet, calm state. It helps to relax to reduce stress and increase awareness of the present moment, achieving inner peace and balance. We learned various meditation techniques. Chanting or singing mantras is another traditional practice to calm the mind and awaken spiritual energy. It's a simple practice that anyone can use to find a moment of peace, no matter where they are or what they are doing right now. Yoga is much more than just asanas, breath or meditation. It includes also the philosophy behind it. The philosophy of yoga teaches us a variety of principles aimed at aligning body, mind and soul and leading a fulfilling life. Everything is somehow interconnected. Yoga encourages us to look inward, explore ourselves, be mindful, and live in the now, not in the past and not in the future. The beauty of the philosophy lessons is that you can somehow see everything as a part of a greater whole. Many insights can be integrated into your everyday life. Our training ends as it began, with a fire ceremony, symbolizing transformation. We've discovered many parallels between yoga and our bicycle journey around the world. Both demand mindfulness, self-reflection, and letting go of expectations. One of the best parts of this month, definitely the people we've met from all corners of the world, who have inspired us every day as we rolled out our yoga mats together. While the training is over, it's clear that we'll continue to learn something new every day. There's still so much more to explore and deepen. And we can already tell you one thing. We will stay in Rishikesh for a few more weeks to pursue another passion. In the beginning was the sound. And just like our thoughts, it has an enormous impact on us and our well-being. Of course, this isn't the end of our bicycle journey around the world. Our bikes are still waiting for us in Thailand, and we will continue cycling southward and then eastward until we reach Japan. So many kilometers, countries, and adventures lie ahead. We are glad you're joining us on this amazing journey. Stay tuned. Namaste.